Well, thank you, and a delayed good evening from Cougar Palace on the campus of WNCC. It's the quarterfinals of the Men's Region 9 Basketball Tournament. The fourth and final game of the day features the host Western Nebraska Cougars, winner of the South Subregion, sporting a record of 22-8 and an 11-game winning streak against the Trappers of Northwest Wyoming Community College. Coach Billy Engel is 2-2 against Northwest Wyoming, 1-2 here at Cougar Palace. Northwest Wyoming, coached by Andy Ward, is 14-17 with an 89-72 loss to Western Nebraska on November 17th on their home court in Powell. In earlier games today in Scott's Bluff, with the losers eliminated, it was Trinidad 93, LCCC 79, Gillette 99, McCook 72. With Trinidad and Gillette facing off tomorrow at 5 o'clock in one of the semifinals. In the game just completed, it was Casper defeating Otero 92-82, with the winner of this game taking on Casper in the 7 p.m. semifinal tomorrow. Northwest Wyoming has no individuals in the top 50 in the NJCAA. Caden Nation is 32nd for Western Nebraska in three-point percentage. Team-wise, Northwest Wyoming is 4th in the country in free throw percentage. They're 32nd as a team in three-point percentage. Western Nebraska is 23rd in fewest turnovers, 32nd in made threes, 41st in attempted threes, and 47th in offensive rebounds. Remember, earlier today in a game heard on KOLT from Casper, the Western Nebraska women had their season end with a 58-52 loss to Western Wyoming. My visit with Coach Billy Engel is next. You're listening to the High Plains Spas and Recreation pregame show. For Hot Springs Spas and Green Mountain Grills, as well as RV and boat service, along with accessories, it's High Plains Spas and Recreation. They sell fun. One more thing before we visit with the coach. I did want to mention some of the top 25 teams in the men's rankings. Some of these may have played some of the Region 9 teams. Salt Lake is ranked third this week. Butler, Kansas is 24th. College of Southern Idaho is 25th. And Western Nebraska did receive some votes in the most recent poll. Again today, Trinidad and Gillette winning. They'll be in a 5 o'clock semifinal tomorrow. And it was Casper just defeating Otero. Game's running a bit long. That's why we're starting a little late today. But the winner between Western Nebraska and Northwest will play Casper at 7 o'clock tomorrow night.
I'm gonna get some ice. Hot as night, y'all. Eat like it, I'm like ice. Like my ice. And I'm gonna play ice. Ice, yeah. Can't believe I made it. Used to wake up, get faded. This is what she was born to me, like I just have all the same shit.
Logos is your home for all your screen printing and embroidery needs. Shop the showroom or have something custom built at Logos, 1344 10th Street in Gehring. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. They're brought to you by Western Nebraska Community College. From diplomas to degrees, it's for me. Learn more at wncc.edu. Northwest Wyoming comes in 14-17. They'll go this way. Milton Santana, 6'2 sophomore from the Dominican Republic. 10.8 points, 3.8 rebounds. He had a dozen the first time against the Cougars. Will Hemme, a 6'1 sophomore from Fort Collins, averages 10.2, 3.8 rebounds. He had 9 points. Coulter Merritt, a 6'1 sophomore out of Star Valley, Wyoming, averaging 13 a game, 8.8 rebounds at only 6'1 in height. Drew Larson, a 6'6 freshman from Fort Collins, 10.1 points, 5.4 rebounds. And Colin Hayes, a 6'6 freshman from Fort Collins, 15.3 points, 4.4 rebounds. He only scored 1 point in that loss at Powell. Yes, all 5 starters are averaging in double digits, and they have Isaiah Halverson to come off the bench at 11.5 points per ball game. Starters for Western Nebraska, J.J. Harris, the 6'4 sophomore out of Tallahassee, 13.2 points, 5.7 rebounds. He had 11 points in the win. Maurice Walker, a 6'4 sophomore from Denver, 8.7 points, 2.7 rebounds. He scored 11 in the win at Powell back in November. Willie Wilson, the 6'1 freshman out of Minneapolis, he's averaging 11.1, 3.2 rebounds. He had 4 points. Travis Easterly, the 6'4 sophomore out of Youngstown, Ohio, 6.6 points, 1.9 rebounds. He scored 7. And the big guy, Stephen Ovia, 6'9 sophomore out of London, 7 points, 4.9 rebounds. He had 7 points the first time these teams got together. And again, that was a long time ago, mid-November in Powell, 89-72, Western Nebraska. Western Nebraska men have won 12 Region 9 titles, the most recent in 2018. Northwest has won 3 in 1967, 69, and in 2015. Games being brought to you today by Valley Auto Locators. They've been helping you find the ride you want since 2016. No gimmicks, just straightforward pricing. great financing options, and an amazing service department to keep your ride running right for as long as you want. That's Valley Auto Locators. So the starting lineups to be introduced, I would think we'll probably have the anthem beforehand since it is the late game here. The fourth out of seven, as we've already mentioned. Trinidad won against LCCC. Gillette beat McCook, and Casper just eliminated Otero. Here's our national anthem before we have the official introduction of starting lineups. Good-sized crowd on hand for this fourth game of the day. Semifinals tomorrow, 5 and 7 o'clock, and the championship now at 5 o'clock, according to Mark Ryan, as he texted me up in Casper when I was doing the women's game to correct the 7 o'clock that they had on the Region 9 on the website. So 5 o'clock championship on Saturday, 5 and 7 semifinals tomorrow. Northwest is in black uniforms. They've got red numerals outlined in white. Western Nebraska will be in their home whites with the dark blue numerals, yellow lettering. They're waiting to be introduced here. Again, Santana, Hemi, Merritt, Larson, and Hayes for Northwest Wyoming. Jacob Price is the assistant coach. Andy Ward, the head coach. This is a team that can play well. They've had a difficult schedule, so 14 and 17, a little misleading. They were 4-8 in the sub-region. Western Nebraska was 11-1 in the south sub-region. One, then a forfeit against Lamar as they had had players in a fight, so six players suspended. They had to forfeit a couple of games. So Western Nebraska has not played for 3 weeks. This is kind of like coming back from the Christmas break. We'll see how it affects them. Opening tip is brought to you by Papa Murphy's Pizza, 2801 Avenue B in Scottsbluff. Papa Murphy's is busting out the triple coverage of pepperoni. The triple pep is back for a limited time. It's covered with giant pepperoni, mini cup pepperoni, and premium pepperoni, all on one delicious pizza. Order online now at papamurphys.com. It's love at 425 degrees. And don't forget to register for the Papa Murphy's Text Club for a sweet deal. Western Nebraska will go left to right here in the first half of action. Coulter Merritt will jump at center. He stands only 6'1". Ovia at 6'9 for Western Nebraska. And the ball's airborne, and Northwest Wyoming has it. It'll be Hemi to bring it across. Bounces a pass onto the right side. Larson with it. He picks up his dribble, now needs some help. 5 second count on. It's knocked free, and it'll be picked up by Hemi of Northwest. Back to Larson. Larson a long way from the hoop. He's got Walker on him defensively. Now off to Hayes, and the ball's taken away. Turnover as here comes Western Nebraska's Willie Wilson, and he'll score the first points of the ball game. First turnover makes it 2-0. Western Nebraska on top. Hemi, the sophomore out of Fort Collins, across with it. Goes to Santana, far side. Santana now dribbles to the left side. Switch on defense. He'll drive deep. Shot is taken away from him. It was knocked away. Turnover. Here comes Western Nebraska. Wilson out to J.J. Harris's three won't go. And the rebound saved by Ovia of Western Nebraska. He'll get it to Easterly. Down low. Layup. Willie Wilson. Wilson has the first four of the ball game. Just over a minute gone in the contest. Hayes, now Hemme. Hemme, left side on the wing to Merritt. Coulter Merritt goes out top to Drew Larson. Larson, Hayes, work it near side, Hemme with it. He'll go right side with it to Merritt, who glances, now passes it low and behind the screen, an easy layup for Will Hemme. So Northwest on the board with 18:24 to go, first half of play. 4-2, Western Nebraska on top. Harris across with it, on the wing to Easterly. Easterly spinning away from the defender, but Northwest catches up with him. Now he'll whip a pass into the right corner. That'll be Walker. He'll feed it low. Ovia lays it in. Ovia, his first two off the assist by Walker, and it's 6-2, Western Nebraska. Hemme, left side on a handoff now to Hayes. Hayes takes it down low. He'll put up an underhand scoop and draw the foul. That will go against J.J. Harris. First foul of the ball game. Western Nebraska on defense, leading at 6-2 in the early going. As Wilson has four, Ovia has two for Western Nebraska, and Hemme has the two for Northwest. But free throws coming now for Colin Hayes. He'll put the first one in, and that makes the score 6-3. Hayes, an 81% free throw shooter, as a team, 76.8 for Northwest. Western Nebraska about 6 points behind that. Hayes hits again. So it's 6-4. Western Nebraska, the two-point lead. They have the basketball. Harris eases across the timeline. He'll be picked up by Hayes. Ovia pops out on the high post to take it. Now Easterly with it. Easterly to Harris in front of the Northwest bench. He'll drive paint, puts it up off the glass. It hesitates and then falls in. So Harris makes it 8-4. Western Nebraska. Hemme across under some pressure from Easterly, but handling it on the right side. Now Hayes with it. Hayes puts it on the floor, comes into the paint, shovels it down low. That'll be traveling. It'll wipe out the Coulter Merritt basket as he took the pass in outside the paint, and by the time he put the shot up, he was on the other side of the iron, and the travel gives it back to Western Nebraska. 8-4. Cougars on top over the Trappers of Northwest Wyoming. Easterly handling it on the far side, the left side, as Western looks at it. He'll drive, puts it off the glass. It won't go. Rebound taken by Santana, Northwest. He'll lead him down on the break himself. Stops, waits for traffic to clear. He's wide open out on top. The three won't go, however, and the rebound taken off by Maurice Walker. Walker, the sophomore out of Denver, Smoky Hill High School, handles it on the right side. Flips down to Ovia. He'll put it up and miss, but he's fouled. Ovia got the shot away, but could not get it to go. And he'll go to the line now and will end up shooting a pair of free throws as the foul will go against Drew Larson, first against Northwest. 8-4, Western Nebraska leading. Ovia, a 61% free throw shooter, puts the first one up and in. Western Nebraska hitting 70.6. I mentioned Northwest at 76.8. Northwest has a slight advantage on overall field goals and a half a point percentage-wise on threes. But Western Nebraska turns it over fewer times. Second free throw goes in for Ovia. That's 10-4 on the scoreboard. Western Nebraska on defense here. Hemme will bring it across. The sophomore out of Fort Collins stumbles, picks the dribble back up, gets it to Hayes. Near side, Merritt. Merritt to Santana. Down low on the block, spinning, tough shot will go in for Colin Hayes. Hayes with four of the six, now for Northwest. 16 minutes, 16 seconds to go. Harris brings it across, he'll give it to Easterly. Man to man, here's Easterly, spins into the paint, and he'll be fouled as he turned to go to the hoop. Lost the handle, but it was because of the foul. And we're quickly going to see a sub, Preston Condia, 6'5 freshman out of Utah, report for Northwest because that's the second foul on Drew Larson. Larson has picked up two in the last half minute of play. Easterly will be at the line. Scoreless on the evening right now, averages 6.6. Hits 3/4 of his free throws on the season. The first one does not go. One more coming, and we're going to see a couple more subs here. Now, I guess it's just Condi. They had to wait until after the first free throw. So Preston Condi, the 6'5 freshman out of Utah, in for Drew Larson. 10-6, Western Nebraska with the lead early in the first half of play. Easterly out of Youngstown, Ohio, puts it up and gets the second one to go. So it's 11-6, Western Nebraska. Hemme, the main ball handler apparently for Northwest, has it across. Merritt, right side, goes top of the circle with it to Hayes. Hemme, left side. Now Santana, top of the circle. He'll work it right side to the new guy, Preston Condi. On top now, Merritt drives into the free throw line, can't get the shot away. Six on the shot clock, here's Hemme to the baseline. He'll put up a 17-footer, it won't go. Rebound tipped up, it won't go. And the rebound finally taken off by Northwest. They'll have a fresh 20 on the shot clock. Hemme, high post, Condi. Condi goes down on the low block with it, nothing developing there for Merritt. Back out to Condi. Now on the baseline, 15-footer won't go, and the rebound off to Western Nebraska. And they're going to have it swatted out of bounds, and it'll be a turnover against, well, let's see. I couldn't see from where I was at. I was blocked off a bit. Who gets it? It will be a turnover on Western Nebraska there first, and it'll be a baseline out of bounds play for Will Hemme of Northwest. Hemme looking low. Nobody was there, so he'll go to Santana in the corner. Santana dribbles out on top with it. He'll work it to Hayes. Hayes has it taken away. Maurice Walker comes up with the steal. Walker into the forecourt. No-look pass down low, and it'll go out of bounds off Northwest. During that timeout, Anthony Simo, the 6'7 freshman out of Cameroon, came in for Western Nebraska. And now we'll see Caden Nation off the bench, the 6'7 freshman out of Peoria. And let's see, Willie Wilson to inbound right side. Wilson will flip it in. J.J. Harris, the transfer out of Chicago State, handling it on top for Western Nebraska. Between the legs on the dribble a couple of times. Now to Simo down low. Simo spins into the paint. Can't get the shot off. Now he'll turn, put it up short. Hemme rebounds Northwest with it. Hemme pushes it down court himself on the right side. He'll reverse it. Here's an open three by Merritt, and it'll be an air ball. Goes out of bounds. Western Nebraska will have the basketball with 14:44 to go in the first half, leading at 11-6. Western Nebraska averages 82.2. Northwest Wyoming, 80.3. Western Nebraska won 89-72 on the 17th of November in Powell. Here's Harris. He'll stop and take a long three-pointer. It's off the back of the iron, and the rebound taken by Preston Condi, flat-footed. He had perfect position. Hemme works right side. Santana back to Hemme. Top of the circle, Condi with it. Now Hayes, here's the alley-oop, and it's a little too high out of bounds. They were trying to get it on the backside to Preston Condi, but it was too high. Goes out of bounds. Western Nebraska has it after the fourth turnover against Northwest. 11-6 yet, the score. 14 minutes, 14 seconds to go in the first half of play. Inbounded to Easterly. He'll give it back to Harris. He'll run the point. Easterly takes the pass, trying to work a screen. Doesn't work there. Good defense by Hemme. Now stops at the free throw line, misses the jumper, and the rebound's out of bounds. And it'll be Northwest with the ball. We're going to have a timeout. 14 minutes exactly. 11-6, Western Nebraska on the West Coast scoreboard. Chuck Swartz with you in the Logos broadcast booth. Logos is your home for all your screen printing and embroidery needs. Shop the showroom or have something custom made at Logos, 1344 10th Street in Gearing. Helping to bring you the ball game today, Ryan's Welding. They sell PJ Texas trailers in a wide variety of sizes, as well as offering a full-service welding shop. And when you come through the doors at Well Life Assisted Living in Scotts Bluff, you'll be treated like family. We're here to help you every step of the way in moving from a familiar environment. Welcome to the community at Well Life Assisted Living in Scotts Bluff. Again, earlier today, I was in Casper for the first round game on the women's Region 9. Unfortunately for Western Nebraska, they lost to Western Wyoming. 58-52. Disastrous first quarter. They rallied in the second, actually had a lead of one at halftime. But second half, Western Wyoming owned that one and ended up with the six-point win. Here's Northwest with it. New player in, Isaiah Halverson. He's the other player, the sixth that averages in double digits for this team. Santana, one dribble. He'll give it to Hemi. Far side, Halverson. Halverson can't find anybody inside. He'll work it deep into the right corner. Hayes with it. He goes out onto the wing. Now between the circles to Hemi. Hemi, a long three that misses off the right side. Didn't draw iron. Harris with it. Long lob pass on ahead. Wilson too far underneath. He'll skip it out to Caden Nation. His three won't go. And the rebound taken by Preston Condi. Good position by him. Ahead to Hemi. He'll sling it to Santana. He's open for a three and hits it. Milton Santana's first bucket of the ball game draws Northwest back to within a pair. 11-9, Western Nebraska the lead and the basketball. Nation, Wilson. Wilson out to Nation. He just missed a three from about that spot. He dribbles slowly toward the right side. He'll try another one. This one goes in. Nation with his first points, and it's a five-point lead for Western Nebraska. 12:50, clock running in the half. Santana nearly lost it there, but scurried to get it. Hayes with it now for Northwest. Condi, left side Santana, and the ball's knocked out of bounds by Western Nebraska. Looks like Maurice Walker to report back in. It's going to give Easterly a breather. 12:38 remains, 14-9 Western Nebraska here in the first half. They jumped out 4-0. Have not trailed. Here's Hemi on the left side of the board to inbound it. And the ball's knocked away. Wilson knocking it away after Hayes cutting on the left side to try and get open. They'll put 20 on the shot clock because of that. It wasn't set properly. So now Hemi to inbound again. He'll lob it down into the paint to Santana, and we're going to have a foul called on Walker as he grabbed on that lob pass. So Walker with his first personal. That'll be two against Western Nebraska. Two also on Northwest. They're on the same player. Into the corner, Halverson. Halverson into the paint. Drills a pass right side. Here's Hayes on the drive. It's blocked from behind by Simo. Simo comes out on the dribble himself. He'll bounce it ahead to Walker. Walker whips the pass near side. Wilson is wide open at the free throw line and misses the shot. Going high for it was Preston Condi of Northwest near steal, but it's picked up by Halverson. Halverson drives. It's rejected. Western Nebraska has it. Nation weaving his way through traffic. Brings it forecourt. Right side, Walker. Walker from downtown misses the three off the front end. Simo keeps it alive momentarily, but Condi yet again a rebound for Northwest. Here comes Hemi to the right side. He'll feed it on to Condi. Condi back to Santana. He'll miss the shot, but it's out of bounds off Western Nebraska. Tried a tough reverse layup there. It did not go, but Western Nebraska could not handle the rebound. 11 minutes, 50 seconds remain. First half, 14-9. Low scoring first half so far. Hemi, who inbounds almost 90% of them, puts it in, but we're going to have see a violation against Western Nebraska, I think, getting a little too close there. That'll be Easterly with a warning. Now, that gives an opportunity for Northwest to sub Teslock Thong into the game, a 6'2 freshman out of Australia. 6.3 points, 2.4 rebounds for him. New man Thong will inbound it. They'll get it down low. And did we have a foul or 3 seconds? Officials talking things over. It'll be a foul on Western Nebraska there. Non-shooting, I believe, so it'll be inbounded again. Foul went against Nation, his first. Here's Northwest. Thong gets the ball in on the wing now. Santana with it. Santana faked a drive, passes back out to Thong. Thong working right side, takes a screen, comes in, puts a five-footer up and in. Looked good on that one, his first two, and it's a three-point Western Nebraska lead, 14-11 with 11 and a half minutes to go. J.J. Harris to Walker. Wilson handles it left side, works right, now passes low. Simo's there and misses the dunk. He was too far underneath, caught the back of the iron. Here's the feed, and it's stolen away by Wilson. Wilson will feed it on to Simo. This time he'll pound it down. Fifth turnover against Northwest Wyoming leads to points. It's 16-11. 11 minutes to go now, first half of play. Thong, left side, bounces it to Halverson. He'll turn, squares up, buries the three-pointer. Averages 11.5. He hits 33% of his threes. Two-point Western Nebraska lead, 16-14. Harris just slowing things down. Simo with it. Now Wilson. Nation between the circles. Left side, Walker. Walker skips the pass low to Wilson. Wilson muscles his way in and puts the reverse layup home. He already has half a dozen. 18-14, Western Nebraska. Thong handling it for Northwest, brings it across with Hemi out of the ballgame. Halverson, Santana, now left side, Hayes. Hayes faked a three, drives, puts it off the glass with his left hand. Simo rebounds. Here comes Western Nebraska. Harris kicks it into the corner to Nation. Nation kicks it out to Wilson. He'll drive, gives it to Simo. He'll lay it in. Nice ball movement by Western Nebraska to make it 20-14. We're inside 10 minutes to go, first half of play. Thong again handling it. Comes left side, races in, feeds it down low. Shot hangs and then goes in for Preston Condi. Condi makes it 20-16, Western Nebraska. Wilson on the right baseline. He'll drive in, spins, drop step. He's rejected out of bounds. It'll be Western Nebraska with the ball with 9:33 to go. We are going to see Coulter Merritt come in and the ball handler Will Hemme back in after a breather on the bench for Northwest. Western Nebraska will inbound it on the right side, leading it 20-16. Easterly will stand beside the official, gets the ball, flips it in, and for the first time, Daniel Bula in the game for Western. Pass down to Simo. He'll whip it right side. Easterly open, fakes, drives, puts it up and in. Quick step by Easterly, his first fielder, and it's 22-16, Western Nebraska. Quickly into the forecourt Northwest. Hemme handling it now as Western Nebraska got back quickly also. Hemme, left side pass, Halverson. Halverson, Thong on the top of the circle with it. Back to Halverson. He hit a three from there. This time Nation right out there in his jersey. Into the left corner. Merritt with it. Merritt finds a screen, drives, lays it up, and misses. Rebound, Simo. Western Nebraska with it. Simo, a flat-footed rebound. Here's Nation squaring up. Three-pointer goes in again. And we've got timeout, Northwest, 8:44 to go. All of a sudden, a 9-point lead, Western Nebraska, 25, Northwest, 16 on the West Coast scoreboard. For the past 27 years, Clean Harbors has been providing environmental and industrial waste management services to the Panhandle. They are the industry-leading provider of treatment, incineration, destruction, and disposal of hazardous waste in North America. Clean Harbors, people and technology creating a better environment. Against the press, Northwest inbounds it. Thong will get it ahead to Hemme in the forecourt. Hemme doubled momentarily, passes off to Thong, who fumbled it but got it back in front of Bula. Thong on the right side, skids to a stop, but keeps dribbling the ball, now loses the handle on it again. Shot clock at 10. Here's Thong down on the right baseline. He'll give it out to Hemme. He'll miss the 15-footer. Simo rebounds. He'll get it to Walker. Long pass. Nation fumbles it away out of bounds. The typical going to run with it before you catch it. Turnover is only the second against Western Nebraska. 8 minutes, 15 seconds remain. First half, 9-point Western Nebraska lead. Hemme will give the ball to Thong after some pressure. by Western Nebraska. Thong works right side, or left side it would be, to Merritt. At to Hemme, fakes his shot. He'll give it away to Cruz Stubbs, who's in for the first time, a 6'4 freshman out of Utah. Hemme on top. Now Thong, shot clock at 9. Thong will dribble on the right side. It's rejected. He'll get it back. Spins. Simo rejects it out of bounds. There'll be one on the shot clock as Simo with an emphatic block there. 7:45 remains in the first half. Still a 9-point lead by Western Nebraska. Thong will inbound. They'll just have to catch and shoot. Simo will come out. Ovia goes back in for Western Nebraska. Thong to inbound in front of the Western Nebraska bench. Looking, he'll flip it low and it's intercepted. We're going to have a foul away from the ball, however, so let's see what happens. I think what happened there, it was such an easy interception because of a hold by Western Nebraska. Bula will pick up the foul. It didn't allow the Northwest player to get where the pass was going. So no turnover, and in fact, 20 on the shot clock. Santana will come back in, Thong out for Northwest. Still 25-16, we've been stuck there for a while. Right side, Hemme to inbound. Hemme zips it into the corner. Halverson makes a bad pass. It's intercepted. Here comes Harris. He'll flip it behind him, but it's intercepted right back. Here's Northwest on the run. Santana with it outside the circle. Kind of slows things down a bit here. Stubbs with it. Stubbs on the weave. Gives to Merritt. Merritt to Santana. Santana spins into the paint, feeds it down low, but we're going to have a whistle, and stepping out of bounds was Merritt as he took the pass on the baseline. Western Nebraska gets it back, still 25-16. 7 minutes, 20 seconds remain here. We're going to have a sub in. Drew Larson is back. Remember, he had those two fouls early. He went out with 16:09 to go. He's back in now at the 7:20 mark. And Western Nebraska with the basketball. Harris, left side, Wilson. Bula between the circles, right side, Easterly. Easterly holds it. He'll give it to Bula, fakes a three, drives in, puts it off the glass and in. Solid move by the sophomore out of Belgium. It's 27-16. Just inside 7 minutes to go as Hemme handles the ball. And we're going to have a reach foul against Easterly as the bounce pass came in low to Larson, and a reach on that one by Easterly, his first foul. Looks like we're going to have a timeout. 6:54 remains, 27-16 Western Nebraska on the Wesco scoreboard. For more than 125 years, Wells Fargo Advisors has created wealth management and investment strategies aimed at achieving our clients' personal financial goals. Call Ryan Windhorst, 632-7561. Together, we'll go far. And Advantage Chiropractic and Acupuncture in Scotts Bluff proudly supports the WNCC Cougars. Dr. Levi Bolin can treat all your chiropractic needs. Call Advantage Chiropractic and Acupuncture at 633-1425. 6 minutes, 54 seconds remain. First half, 27-16. Western Nebraska, winner of this one, takes on Casper in the 7 o'clock semifinal tomorrow night in the Men's Region 9 tournament. Casper winning over Otero in the game just finished up. And before that, we had Gillette and Trinidad winning games. They'll meet in the first semifinal. Here's Northwest inbound left side following the timeout. Looking low, nothing there. Hemme gets it into the corner. Drew Larson airballs a three. Harris has it. He'll clear it ahead to Bula. Bula reverses it. J.J. Harris handling it for Western Nebraska. 11-point lead, 20 on the shot clock. Wilson. Now Harris left side, bounces it down to Ovia on the baseline. Ovia spins, goes down. He'll be called for traveling as he slipped. Tried to hold his position, but couldn't. That'll only be the fourth turnover on Western Nebraska. Seven against Northwest in the early going. Now we'll see Larson, who had, Hayes, who had gone out earlier. He's back in for Northwest. He'll replace Crew Stubbs, the 6'4 freshman from Utah. Ball inbounded, and Will Hemme bringing it to the timeline. Picked up by Wilson on the weave. Larson, Santana, Merritt, left side. Down onto the baseline, Larson with it. He'll skip a pass far side. Hemme squares up, long way from the hoop. He'll back away. Left side pass comes to Larson. Here's Colin Hayes, four on the shot clock, Santana, and we're going to have a foul called on an illegal screen against Northwest, which will be another turnover against Northwest. That'll be Colin Hayes called for his first. Only three fouls against Northwest, five on Western Nebraska, so neither team in the one-and-one as of yet. We're now inside 6 minutes as Harris eases across the timeline, bounces it to Easterly on the wing. Easterly takes a screen left. Nothing there, now bounces it to Ovia on the right block. He drives in, puts it up. We're going to have an offensive foul called on Ovia as the defense was set properly by Drew Larson. So Ovia with his first. So now Western Nebraska with their sixth, and it's also the fifth turnover. Still 27-16, Western Nebraska. Just under 10 minutes when Northwest scored last. They'll bounce it right side. Larson works to Hayes, and we're going to have a foul. And this will result in a 1-1 as Easterly will pick up his second. And that is the seventh, so 1-1 coming here for Northwest. Coulter Merritt looking for his first points. He averages 13. He had a dozen last time. He's a 68% free throw shooter. Western Nebraska by 11. Misses short. Rebound taken off by Maurice Walker. He turns it into a dribble, into the forecourt with it. Finds an opening, puts the 10-footer up. It bounces twice, comes away. Rebound taken off by Ovia. And we're going to have a foul called down low as Ovia is trying to be tied up there, but Merritt will pick up the foul instead. That'll be the fourth against Northwest, only the first on Merritt, so non-shooting, and it'll be inbounded by Wilson on the right side. He'll lob it to Bula out on top. Tries to feed it low, and good hands by Merritt steals the ball. Here's Merritt driving on the left side. Defender will go up in the air, and a foul will be called, as crashing hard will be Coulter Merritt, and they'll have to decide which Western Nebraska player is going to pick up the foul here. That will be Bula with his second. He and Ovia were both up in the air and contact made. They'll say Bula first. So at the line now, Coulter Merritt to shoot two shots. He missed a 1-1 just seconds ago. This one misses off the right side. 68% free throw shooter, but he was well short on the first one, and that one barely drew iron on the right side as it caught the backboard. 5 minutes, 17 seconds to go. 27-16, Western Nebraska with the lead. Merritt bends the knees, puts it up, and an air ball. Shaking his head in disgust as he heads back on defense. One of his teammates gives him an encouraging pat. He'll be back. Harris against the press. Wilson on ahead. Ovia. Ovia, Wilson, now Harris again. Harris calling out the play. Shot clock at 15, so plenty of time. Wilson with it on the right wing. Wilson backs away, takes a screen to the left side, goes into the corner with it. Walker launches the three. It won't go, tipped up, but now Northwest with it. Merritt clears it. Here's Hemme across. Hemme gets the ball down low, and it'll go in off the glass. That was a tough shot by Merritt for his first two. 27-18, he makes up for the pair of misses on the free throw line. I don't know, coach never thinks you do. Now a pass by Walker is intercepted, so another turnover on Western Nebraska. Here's Merritt across. Merritt works right side, drives, puts it in. Boy, there was nobody in front of him there, and Western Nebraska will take a timeout because all of a sudden that lead is down to 7 at 27-20 with 4:20 remaining in the half. on the Wesco scoreboard. Minutes, 20 seconds remaining in the half. 27-20 Western Nebraska. Just a moment ago, they had a 27-16 lead. Press on by Northwest out of the timeout. Walker takes it. Harris, now Wilson. Wilson back to J.J. Harris. Harris near the timeline, has it across, working against Santana. Western Nebraska hasn't scored since they put 27 up with about 6:50 to go in the half. Here's Harris. Harris comes into the paint, no-look pass down low, shot won't go, Simo rebounds, he'll put it off the glass, it won't go again, and the rebound taken off by Merritt. Boy, he has a ton of them in this one. Now Hemme across, it's tipped away. Long pass by Walker, and Wilson lays it in. Following the turnover, it was his hands that knocked it away, and Western Nebraska has a 9-point lead, 29-20. Santana hands to Hemme. 3.5 minutes to go, 9-point lead, first half. Off to Drew Larson. Larson on the cut, down to Hayes. Hayes spins on the baseline, puts it in. Hayes with half a dozen off a tough shot there, makes it 29-22. Walker takes the inbound, gives it to Harris. Harris across with 3:14 remaining, first half of play. Whip the ball down to Walker, get it outside to Nation. His three-pointer won't go. Rebound taken off by Wilson. He misses again, and it's Northwest that comes out with it. A couple of close-in shots have missed. Here's the pass down low. Missing, however, is Drew Larson. Rebound, Harris. Harris pushes him down court, takes it left side, puts it in off the glass. 31-22 with 2:46 to go. Western Nebraska here in the first half. Santana, Hemme between the circles, takes the pass, calls out the play, bounces it left side, Larson. Larson feeds it off. Here's Merritt. His three won't go. Rebound tracked down in the corner by Maurice Walker. Western Nebraska on the run, but Walker makes a bad pass. Northwest has it. They'll come up with numbers. 3-on-2. Santana wide open left corner but misses. Rebound taken by Caden Nation. Nation for Western Nebraska. Back to Wilson. Wilson fakes, drives, gives it to Simo. He'll miss the shot. Simo battling for it, and we'll have a jump ball called. Merritt and Simo both tumbling to the court there, and the possession arrow will be in Western Nebraska's favor. Northwest will sub. We're going to see Preston Condi back in. Condi scored a couple after coming off the bench earlier in the half. 31-22, Western Nebraska leading it. Wilson comes down to take it out of bounds. Handed the ball by the official. Looks low, nothing there, so he'll flip it out to Harris on the wing. Harris dribbling to the left side, backs off. Loses the handle, picks it up, turns it into a dribble. We're inside 2 minutes to go, first half. Harris takes a Simo screen to the right side, backs off, launches the three, and hits it. Harris not to be denied there. It's a dozen-point lead now for Western Nebraska. Hemme, a good ball handler, brings it across, trying to direct traffic. He wants Hayes to be on the right side. He'll take the pass there. Now the cut down to Santana, and he'll lay it in. Santana, nice layup for him, makes it a 10-point Western Nebraska lead. We're at a minute 20 to go, first half of play. Western Nebraska has never trailed in this game. Here's Harris to the hoop, and he'll be fouled. Harris split the defense on the side, and a couple of defenders coming to help out. And the foul will go against Coulter Merritt. That'll be his second. It'll be a shooting foul. So Harris at the line to shoot his first free throws. Western Nebraska, 3 out of 4. Easterly's made one of his two. Ovia made both of his, and that's it. For Northwest, Hayes is 2 for 2. Merritt's 0 for 3 at the stripe. Minute 15 to go as Harris puts it up short. He'll have one more coming. Western Nebraska leading it by 10. Western Nebraska averages about 39 rebounds a ball game. Northwest averages 37. Turnovers, 11.8 for Western Nebraska, 14.8 for Northwest. Harris hits this free throw, so he has one of two. Western Nebraska leads it 35-24. Now the ball to be brought up by Thong. Also in the game for Western now is Elijah Burney. He's defending on him. Thong with it out on top. Thong, right side pass, Hayes. Hayes goes to the baseline, spins into the paint, puts it in. Smooth-looking move by Colin Hayes to make it 35-26. Western Nebraska has the basketball and the lead. We're in the final minute of play here in the first half. Harris wanting to get people moved out of the way, so he has a little room to maneuver here against Hayes. Takes it in. His shot's or pass is rejected. It'll be saved by Northwest. Turnover on Western's their eighth. Here's the alley-oop try. It won't go, but it will be a foul on Western Nebraska here. That'll go against Wilson, I believe. Yes, Willie Wilson with his first. 27.9 seconds. They tried the alley-oop to Merritt coming from the weak side. He was fouled as he got his hand on the ball. He'll shoot two. Merritt 0 for 3 in the game. This one will go in. So it's just a mind game after you miss a couple. He gets this one to go, however. And let's see. We're going to have official thought that Harris was going out. I think he is because he's kind of holding his back there. Looks like we'll have Easterly in. Well, we've got a timeout. 27.9 seconds, 35-27, Western Nebraska on the West Coast scoreboard. Western Nebraska leads at 35-27 with 27.9 seconds to go. And Merritt back at the line to shoot the second free throw down. Timeout in between. So he'll have the opportunity to draw his team back to within seven. They have trailed by as much as 11. He misses this one. Burney had the rebound. It was knocked out of bounds by Northwest. Hayes stumbling on the baseline there, avoided injury though as he regained his balance, so good to see that. 26 and a half seconds to go. Western Nebraska will inbound. Burney to Easterly. Three-quarter court press. Santana picks Travis Easterly up, but he's into the forecourt with it. Easterly between the circles with it, not wanting anybody out to set a screen. Shot clock is off. Easterly reverses it to Wilson. Wilson trying to work to the left side, draws a double team. His pass is deflected, but taken in by Simo. Here comes Nation. He'll give it off, and the layup missed by Elijah Burney at the buzzer. So at halftime, Western Nebraska leads it by 8 over Northwest, 35-27. Thank you. Western Nebraska leads at halftime 35-27. They've never trailed. They jumped out 4-0. They led 16-11 with 11:05 to go. Northwest cut it to 20-16 just inside 10 minutes. But then a 7-0 run by Western Nebraska, and it was 27-16. But Northwest fought back. They had a 4-0 run of their own. Then Western Nebraska scored, but the teams traded buckets till there was a minute 41 to go. It was 34-22, the biggest lead, 12 for Western Nebraska at that point. But Northwest got some hoops late and trails it by 8 at halftime, 35-27. We'll look at scoring when we come back. Western Nebraska leading it at halftime, 35-27 over Northwest, trying to get into the semifinals to take on Casper tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. Let's look at scoring for Northwest Wyoming first. Colin Hayes has 8. He's 2-for-2 at the line with 3 two-pointers. Right about his average. He averages 15.3. Remember, Northwest has 6 players that average double digits. All 5 starters tonight are in double figures on the season. And Isaiah Halverson comes off the bench in doubles. 5 points each, Milton Santana and Coulter Merritt. Santana, a 2 and a 3. Merritt, a couple of 2s, and he's 1 for 5 at the free throw line. 3 points for that aforementioned Isaiah Halverson on a 3. 2 points each, Teslock Thong and Preston Condi. Will Hemme, the playmaker, also with 2. He averages 10.2. Playing but not scoring, Crew Stubbs and Drew Larson. For Western Nebraska, they have been led at halftime by Willie Wilson and J.J. Harris, each with 8. Wilson has 4 two-point buckets. Harris, 2 twos at 3 and 1 out of 2 at the line. 6 points, Caden Nation on a pair of 3s. Then it's 4 points each, Stephen Ovia and Anthony Simo, the big guys equaling what they normally do. Between them, they'll average about 14 points a ball game and 11 rebounds, but they each play about half of the time. Ovia is 2 for 2 at the line with a fielder. Simo has 2 two-point goals. Travis Easterly with 3. He's missed 1 of the 2 free throws, has a two-pointer to his credit. 2 points for Daniel Bula. Playing but not scoring, Maurice Walker and Elijah Burney. Both teams have played 9, and 7 have scored in the first half. When we look at the numbers, they are courtesy, of course, of Dr. Levi, as he's been a big supporter of Western Nebraska for a long time. Advantage Chiropractic and Acupuncture proudly supports the WNCC Cougars. Dr. Levi Bolin can be reached at 633-1425. He brings us the stats at halftime and in the post game. We're at halftime, 35-27, Western Nebraska on the West Coast scoreboard. Western Nebraska, an 8-point lead at halftime, rebounding. 24-15 advantage for Western Nebraska. They've been led by Simo with half a dozen, then a trio with three, Ovia, Walker, and Harris. For Northwest, their leading rebounder, Preston Condi, with four. Nobody else with more than one right now out of their 15. Turnovers are even at nine apiece. We'll look at the shooting stats here in just a moment. I want to remind you, however, that Intralinx, supporting computer systems in the Panhandle for over 20 years. With the team at Intralinx, technology isn't an obstacle, it's an opportunity. Contact Jennifer Yurdialis, your local five-star lender with Castle & Cook Mortgage, for a simple, friendly, and fast loan process for your home purchase or refinance. Contact Jennifer, Castle & Cook Mortgage, the key to your castle. Northwest at halftime is 2 out of 9 on threes. That's 22%. 9 of 19 for 47% on two-pointers. Overall, they're at 39%, 11 out of 28. Western Nebraska, 3 out of 9 on threes. That's 33%. 11 of 25 for 44% on twos. Overall, 41.2%. For Western Nebraska. Off the bench, Western Nebraska has a dozen points. Northwest has seven. And second chance points working down low. Western Nebraska with five. And Northwest hasn't scored any off of those as of yet. So Western Nebraska has had a 12-point lead. This one right now is an 8-pointer at 35-27. Update you in case you didn't hear scores from earlier today in Scott's Bluff at Cougar Palace at the Men's Region 9 Tournament. Trinidad defeated LCCC 93-79 after trailing at halftime. Gillette over McCook 99-72. And Casper ended up winning their ball game against Otero. They had a pretty good lead for most of the game. Otero cut it down late, but it ended up 92-82. Casper winning. Of course, the losers of those games had their season end. Winner of this one takes on Casper at 7. 5 o'clock semifinal tomorrow has Trinidad against Gillette. In the women's game heard on KOLT from Casper, I was up there for the 12:30 game. Western Nebraska lost to Western Wyoming by a score of 58-52 to end their year at 25-7. Second straight year they lost in the quarterfinals to Western Wyoming. Western Wyoming went 3-0 this year against Western Nebraska, and that's tough to do, beat a team three times. Dooley Oil's been providing great service since 1968. They're your distributors for premium Shell lubricants and Howe's fuel additive in Wyoming, Nebraska, and Colorado, and the extreme diesel fuel provider in the three-state region. Helping to bring you the game today, Viera Wireless. They have hometown roots, global reach. Viera Wireless in Scott's Bluff. We're at halftime. Teams are warming up for the second half of play. Might mention earlier today, as Western Nebraska now playing in their 31st game of the year, had Harris, Walker, Wilson, Easterly, and Ovia as the starters. Ovia's 24th start of the year. Easterly's 17th. Wilson also 17. Walker, 29. And Harris, his 26th start. So kind of a rotation that's being settled on, I guess you would say, late in the year. Western Nebraska's won 11 in a row coming into this ball game. They lost their first game in the Region 9 to Trinidad on this very court, then turned around and won every game after that, including a one-pointer at Trinidad. Then with the forfeit, Lamar had to give Western Nebraska due to not having enough players due to a fight that had suspended half a dozen Lamar players. Western Nebraska clinched the South Sub-Region and has gone 3 weeks without playing. It's almost like the Christmas break, I guess you could say, and they don't have time to kind of acclimate themselves and get back into it, because one loss and you're done. Russell's Automotive, your family-owned go-to for all of your quality automotive repair needs, helping to bring you the broadcast along with Highway 92 Pit Stop. That's Melbita's gas station and convenience store, and they're ready to serve you. For almost 40 years, the name Scott's Bluff Body and Paint has meant excellence. Count on them to get you back on the road as good as new. They now need to give a bouquet to sports director Chris Cottrell of the KNEB group of stations. He was willing to step in for me here in case something happened and I wouldn't make it back from Casper from doing the women's game. And in fact, was ready to work tomorrow in case Western Nebraska won and I'd still be in Casper, not able to get back and do the men. But Chris always willing to do what's necessary for the coverage for the listeners. We're ready to go. 20 on the clock, 35-27 on the scoreboard, and it's Hemi handling it for Northwest Wyoming as they have first possession. Left side, Santana. He'll work high post with it to Drew Larson. Feeds down to Hayes, and a foul will be called. Western Nebraska doubling down on him, getting a lot of people in the way, and the foul will go against Stephen Ovia and be his second of the contest. So Ovia picks it up 10 seconds into the second half of play. Free throw by Colin Hayes goes in. He's 3 for 3 in the game, an 81% free throw shooter, so no surprise there. That makes the score 35-28. Northwest crawling back into it now, 35-29. Western Nebraska's first possession of the second half. Harris with it. He'll hand to Wilson. Ovia setting a screen for him on the left side. Step back by Wilson. A long two hangs and goes off, and we're going to have a foul called against Western Nebraska trying to get some rebounding position here. So not the start Western Nebraska would have hoped for here in the half. Foul goes against, I have to wait and see, I think Ovia again, because Western Nebraska has Simo up off the bench. And he will come in. So, yes, Ovia, they haven't put it up on the board yet, but I'm pretty sure three is Simo has to come in. Here's Northwest with it. They can make things interesting. They're down half a dozen. Hemi on the right side. He'll hand it away. Hayes with it quickly. Santana, now Hayes on the left baseline, trying to back his way in. He'll hook a pass down low, and we're going to have a foul called. Nope, he was out on the baseline, stepped out. So Northwest turns it over as he was pinned in underneath and stepped out, took a little jab step, I think, and that got him out of bounds, so the turnover gives it back to Western Nebraska. Good ball movement there by Northwest. They would have had a reverse layup coming. Easterly finds Walker on the far side. Walker scoreless in the ball game right now. Harris, he'll take a long three-pointer and hit it. Wow, second three of the game for Harris. 38-29. Down at the other end, though, answering back quickly will be Colin Hayes, 38-31. Now backing his way in, Wilson puts it up and in. Wilson, not to be denied. 40-31, Western Nebraska, 18-38, clock running here in the second half. Hemi with it in front of the Northwest bench, top of the circle with it to Hayes. Hayes looking around, nobody, now gets it down low into the paint. Hooked the ball out into the corner, Hemi for three, and he's got his first field goal of a three-pointer in the game. Five for him in the game, half of his average, 40-34. 6-point Western Nebraska lead, 18 minutes, 10 seconds remain. Harris will bounce it to Wilson, left side. Man-to-man by Northwest, of course. Lob pass comes into Simo in the paint. He'll turn, put it up. It'll be a block foul and an and-one situation for Western Nebraska as Drew Larson will pick up his third personal. Remember, he had two in the first 3 minutes and 51 seconds of the ball game. Now picks up his third. Simo gets the point. He'll be at the line. A 66% free throw shooter on the season. 8-point lead back up there for Western Nebraska in the first 2 minutes. This one rims out, and the rebound taken off by Merritt. Merritt waits for traffic to clear, brings it across. Hemi deep into the right corner. Here comes a three-pointer that won't go off the back iron. Harris, long pass up court to Walker. Walker, three on three, hesitation move, puts it into the paint. Simo off glass scores. 10-point lead, Western Nebraska. 17:36 remaining. Santana is tied up. Oh, they didn't call anything, but the shot goes. It won't go in. Rebound Northwest. Merritt puts it in. Looked like a tie-up, but nothing was called, and resulting in Northwest getting a layup to make it 44-36. Harris slows the pace, brings it across, finds Wilson on the left side. Wilson looking low. Simo trying to battle in there against Drew Larson, but goes into the right corner. Here comes the drive by Easterly. Tough 15-footer goes in as he fades away for his second fielder of the ball game. 10-point lead as the team's just trading back at buckets right here. Hemi's pass knocked out of bounds by Wilson. Hemi will inbound just outside the arc on the right side with 21 on the shot clock, 16:46 on the game clock. He'll flip it to Santana, back to Hemi. Now Santana down low onto the block, trying to muscle his way in. Merritt. Merritt turns, puts it up and in. Merritt, tough shot with a couple of defenders in his face, 46-38. Here's Walker, makes a bad pass. It'll be out of bounds, trying to hit Wilson, cutting across. And the turnover will give it to Northwest with 16:29 to go, 46-38, Western Nebraska. Little one-man press by Wilson, but now it'll be dropped off. Hemi will bring it across the timeline. Hemi goes high post with it on the left side to Merritt. Merritt dribbling slowly. Wanted a backdoor cut. It wasn't there. Now they'll get the ball down low. Hayes puts it up and misses but draws the foul. Hayes fouled by Simo. And that's Anthony Simo's first of the ball game. Member Ovia on the bench with three right now. Well, Colin Hayes has been a perfect 4-for-4 at the stripe. He'll have two more coming here. At halftime, 3 out of 7 for Northwest as Merritt was 1-for-5. Free throw comes off short this time by Hayes. Score remains 46-38. Western Nebraska was 4-of-6 at halftime. Ovia had hit both of his. Easterly and Harris had each gone 1-for-2. 46-38. 16 minutes, 11 seconds remain in the contest. Free throw goes in, so it's a 7-point lead as Hayes goes 1 out of 2. He's now 5 out of 6. Western Nebraska unable to pull away. Northwest hasn't cut it inside 5. Here's the pass down to Caden Nation, who's in. Nation will turn and draw the foul. Merritt got him on the way up, and Coulter Merritt will have his third personal foul of the ball game. So Larson and Merritt with 3 for Northwest, Ovia with 3 for Western Nebraska, and Caden Nation to shoot his first free throws of the ball game. He had a couple of threes in that first half. Missed his first one, hit the next one, missed one, and hit another. He gets the free throw to crawl over the edge and go in, so it's an 8-point lead, 47-39. We're going to see Harris, who had been out briefly, take over inside there. Simo will go back on defense. Nation has one more coming, and it rattles around and then hesitates and falls in. So Caden Nation gets a couple. Here's the double-team trap on, but Halverson with it in the backcourt. Get it to Hemi. Hemi across the timeline. 48-39, Western Nebraska after a pair of free throws there. Here's Halverson. Halverson steps into the paint. It won't go, but gets his own rebound. Puts it off the glass short. Nation with it. Easterly into the forecourt in a hurry. No-look pass low, and Simo dunks it home. That inspires the crowd. Northwest coming back quickly, 50-39 with 15:20 to go in the ball game. Western Nebraska by 11. Near side, Hayes with it. Condi back in. Halverson, top of the circle, Santana. Hemi with it, near side. Out to Hayes, shot clock inside 10. Here comes Halverson on the drive. He'll put it up, and he'll be fouled. Halverson hesitated, got the defender in the air, and that'll be Simo picking up the foul. His second. Coming a minute and 11 seconds apart, so he has two. Ovia on the bench with three. Halverson, who averages 11 and a half off the bench, has a three-pointer to his credit. These will be the first free throws that he has shot in the ball game, and he'll hit this one. So 50 to 40. Western Nebraska by 10. Exactly 15 minutes to go in the contest. Halverson, a freshman out of Sacramento, California. Puts it in. 79% free throw shooter. He's 2 for 2. 50-41. Nation will inbound it. Harris will bring it up. Now off to Wilson. Back to Harris. Still in the backcourt. Harris brings it across. 9-point lead. Wilson in front of the Western bench. Simo. Harris left side. Nation posted down low, stops, 15-footers off the back end. Halverson rebounds for Northwest. Hemi, long pass, comes ahead to Hayes. He'll take the three and hit it. Hayes in perfect position on that one, in perfect form, now has 16. It's a 6-point lead for Western Nebraska. Wilson trying to take the pass from Easterly. It was knocked out of bounds, and it'll be Western Nebraska with the basketball. 50-44. Little run here by the Northwest Trappers. 5-0 run has gotten them back within six. Harris works to the right side. Backs off. The step back three goes in again. Boy, Harris has hit three of them in the ball game. 9-point lead, 53-44. Hemi across. Easterly greets him at the timeline. 9-point lead, Western Nebraska. They're on defense. Condi takes the pass right side, works it left side. Hayes drives paint, puts the shot up. It won't go. Rebound, Halverson of Northwest. Puts it outside for a wide open three, and it'll go in for Preston Condi. His first three of the game, 53-47. 13 and a half minutes to go. Western Nebraska still with the lead, and now a foul called against Hemi of Northwest as he went for the interception and bumped into the Western player. His first foul. We're going to have a timeout. 13:29 to go. 53-47. Western Nebraska by 6 on the Wesco scoreboard. Northwest has outscored Western Nebraska 20-18 in the half, but trails 53-47. Team Auto Center is helping bring you the broadcast. They're the home of the lifetime warranty on every new vehicle from Team Auto. And Trans Systems, it's a sweet haul in this sweet community. Dooley Oil's been providing great service since 1968. They're your distributors for premium Shell lubricants and Howe's fuel additive in Wyoming, Nebraska, and Colorado, and the extreme diesel fuel provider in the three-state region. Timeout over. Northwest breaking the huddle last. They'll head down to the defensive end here as Western Nebraska will inbound. Harris right in front of the Western Nebraska bench to inbound it. He'll go outside to Easterly with it. Easterly down low on the block. Here's Wilson spinning his way in. He'll flip it up. It comes off the back iron, and we're going to have a rebounding foul. And this will go against Northwest's Milton Santana. His first. So it'll be a shot for Western Nebraska now, as they're calling that a shot in the act of shooting for Willie Wilson. Wilson's first one swishes home for his first free throw on his first attempt. He has 11. Western Nebraska Back up by 7, 54-47. Wilson bends the knees for the second one and hits it. So 55-47, Western Nebraska. Hemme will be pressured by Easterly. Goes behind the back, now has it across the timeline. Hemme hands it away to Halverson. Halverson to Hayes. Santana, Halverson posted low on the left side, trying to muscle his way in. He'll put the shot up and miss the shot. Simo outleaps everybody for the rebound for Western Nebraska. Harris gets it to Nation on the right side. Nation drives on the right, and it's going to be out of bounds, and they'll say off Nation for a turnover. Western Nebraska gives the ball up with 12 minutes, 51 seconds to go. Halverson will inbound it to Hemme, who handles it about 99% of the time when he's in the ball game at the point position. He's across, Easterly pressuring him all the way. Bounce pass to Condi. Condi gives up the dribble. Now needs some help. He'll hand it away to Hemme. Back to Condi. Condi drives to the free throw line, gives it to Halverson. Halverson takes the 15-footer. It's off the left side. Rebound, however, Northwest. Rebound again, Northwest. And the Santana layup on the reverse shot off glass makes it 55-49. A lot of offensive rebounds for Northwest that time down. Here's Easterly trying to answer and does so with a long three. So 58-49, 12 minutes, 4 seconds remain in the game. Western Nebraska by 9 again. Hemme hands it away to Hayes, the freshman out of Fort Collins. Left side, Santana. High post, Condi. He'll lob it low. It's tipped away. Turnover against Northwest. Long pass too far. Wilson saves it in, however, to Simo. Simo pulls up on the baseline, makes a skip pass to Nation that was nearly intercepted, but Nation has it. Now he'll get it down to Simo, and he'll score over Halverson. 8 points this half for Simo, 12 in the game. Here's Santana. Down low, back outside. Halverson's three is off wildly, but the rebound Northwest, and it's going to be knocked out of bounds by Western Nebraska. So Northwest will have possession, but now trailing it by 11, 60-49. Bula and Elijah Burney in. Burney played late in the first half. Bula in midway through the first half. Bula has 2 points. Burney yet to score. Here's Hemme to inbound on the left side. Hemme gets it down low, easy layup for Preston Condi as they set the screen and he had nobody in front of him. 60-51, Western Nebraska by 9. We're nearing 11 minutes to go in the ball game. Harris, Bula, now Burney, left side. Burney backs off, trying to get it inside to Simo. He will. Simo backs his way in, and we're going to have an offensive foul against Simo. Put an elbow out to clear some space, and Simo will have his third personal. So both he and Ovia have three, the big guys for Western Nebraska. Coming in is Coulter Merritt along with Crew Stubbs for Northwest. Stubbs played briefly in the first half. We're going to have a timeout. 10:51 to go, 60-51. Western Nebraska as Northwest just won't go away. Care Medical Services in Scotts Bluff. For all of life's little emergencies, you have a choice when it comes to your health care, and at Quick Care Walk-In Clinic, we're here to help. Quick Care Medical Services in Scotts Bluff. Western Nebraska led it at halftime 35-27. They're currently up by 9 as Northwest just keeps chipping away, and then Western Nebraska answers back. 10 minutes, 51 seconds to go in regulation and in somebody's season, barring an overtime. Now, the officials still gathered with one of the officials over at the score table. So Coach Andy Ward gathers his team back together for a moment to take a little more time for some coaching Billy Engel just staring out at his team right now as they prepare to get back to work here. Not sure what the conversation is about over at the score table. One thing about the region, there's usually a supervisor of officials who will set in. He can watch video on this. In the women's game today, a bucket was disallowed by Western Wyoming as it went in after the shot clock had expired. It was taken off about a minute later as the supervisor of officials called the three-man crew over and explained the situation. I'm not sure there. The score did not change. It's still 60-51 here. It'll be Northwest inbound the ball. Hemme takes the pass. They'll double him, so he'll get the ball back to Merritt. Merritt still in the backcourt. Now it's ahead to Hemme in the forecourt, and he'll throw the ball on the far side, barely staying inbounds was Hayes. Good balance on his part, but now he loses the handle on it out of bounds. Turnover against Northwest with 10:36 to go. Western Nebraska has a 9-point lead, 60-51. Western Nebraska's 4 out of 5 in this half. Northwest 5 out of 6. Elijah Burney handles it, gives it to Harris. J.J. Harris between the legs on the drive, brings it in, puts the shot up, won't go. Hemme with it. Hemme rebounding for Northwest, turns it into a dribble, turns it into a fast break. He'll feed it down low on the block, reverse layup, goes in for Preston Condi. Condi makes it a 60-53 ball game. Elijah Burney handling it for Western Nebraska. Bula with it on the left side. Bula shakes and bakes. Can't get free, however. He'll give the ball to Easterly. Easterly trying to break through a double team. Does so, but now loses the handle on it. Here comes Northwestern on the drive. Hemme puts it off the glass and in. Hemme makes Western pay, and it's a 5-point game, 60-55. The drive, Burney is fouled as he goes up for the shot down low on the block, and he'll go to the line to shoot. Western Nebraska has answered every time Northwest has put a run on. Can they do it again? Burney will shoot his first 2 free throws of the night. Scoreless, he averages 3.8. and is a 63% free throw shooter. Stares at the hoop, puts it up and in. Hit the front, the board, and falls in. Western Nebraska back up by 6 with one more coming. After the bucket by Condi there, Western Nebraska took 3 seconds to get it down and try a layup where the foul was called. Burney puts the second one up and in. So he gets both of them to make it a 62-55 ball game. Hemme across, Burney on him defensively. Right side pass to Stubbs. Stubbs zips it out on top. Merritt, now Hemme, left side. Hemme, Hayes, top of the circle with it now. And we're going to have an illegal screen set here. That one will go against Coulter Merritt of Northwest, and that will be his 4th personal foul of the ball game. It comes with 9:20 to go. So he'll come out, and we will see Drew Larson go back in. Larson averages 10.1. He's scoreless. That might be part of the reason it's a 7-point Western Nebraska lead. Burney, forecourt, right side, and we're going to have an illegal foul, illegal screen called against Caden Nation of Western Nebraska. So back-to-back offensive screens called for fouls, and the turnover gives it to Northwest. Just over 9 minutes to go in the ball game. Hemme picks the pace up to the right side. Burney stops him. Pass goes to Hayes. Now on top to Stubbs. Reverse the pass. Merritt way outside on the arc. Goes left corner with it. The arc now to Hayes on the wing. Hayes trying to shake and bake, dumps a pass down low, and the layup goes in for Drew Larson for his first points as he took a pass in just avoiding the defenders. Burney backs off. It's a 5-point game again, 62-57. Burney to the right side, gives to Nation. Nation behind the back on the dribble, ball's taken away from him. Wide open, down court, Merritt puts it down. The two-handed stuff puts him in double digits, and it's a 3-point game. 8:20 to go, 62-59. Western Nebraska needs to answer. Nation between the circles, now Bernie with it. Bernie on the left side, working one-on-one against Stubbs. He'll launch a three. It's off iron. Long rebound taken by Wilson, or Walker of Western Nebraska. Walker down to Wilson on the baseline. Step back, 15-footer goes in for Willie Wilson. Big bucket there. 5-point lead, Western Nebraska, 7:48 to go. Merritt handling it for Northwest. Crew Stubbs, freshman out of Utah. He'll go top of the circle to Hayes. Pass is intercepted by Wilson. Wilson, Bernie, Wilson. Wilson gives it off, and Walker lays it in for his first points. 66-59, 7.5 minutes to go in the ball game. Western Nebraska getting a couple of crucial hoops there. Hemme will bring it across. We're going to have an offensive foul called against Colin Hayes, who knocked Walker down. Hayes will have his second personal, but it's also the 15th turnover against Northwest Wyoming, and Western Nebraska will have it. Bernie comes out. Harris comes back in for Western Nebraska. 66-59, Western Nebraska. Harris takes the ball from Walker and walks it up toward the timeline. Bounces a pass to Walker on the right side. Now Wilson again. Wilson's hit a couple of tough shots against good defense by Northwest. He's feeling it. He'll try a three, but it doesn't go. Harris has it. He'll put it up and in. Is it and one, or is it on the floor? Officials are going to get together and talk for a moment as to exactly what the foul is. I have not seen an indication that there will be a bucket, but Hayes picks up the foul. That'll be his third. He's picked up two and three, 18 seconds apart. And Western Nebraska doesn't get the points there. It'll be a one and one because Northwest is over the seven foul limit. Harris to shoot. He's one out of two in the ball game. He'll earn the bonus as he swishes that one home. 67-59, Western Nebraska, 7 minutes, 2 seconds to go in the contest. Winner takes on Casper tomorrow in one of the semifinals. Harris misses this one, but Nation has the rebound. He'll feed it down low. Wilson lays it in. Big offensive board, and it's now 69-59 as we get inside 7 minutes to go in the game. And we're going to have timeout, Northwest. 6:44 to go, 69-59, Western Nebraska on the Wesco scoreboard. Western Nebraska has made 8 out of 9 free throws in this half. Northwest has made 5 out of 6. So both teams shooting it well. At halftime, only 3 of 7 for Northwest, 4 of 6 for Western Nebraska. But a 69-59 lead as a 7-0 run by Western Nebraska has increased that 3-point lead they had with 8:20 to go to 69-59 with 6:55. There's now a timeout at 6:44 to go in the game. J.G. Elliott Insurance Center helping to sponsor the game today. Our experienced agents and tailored coverage help protect the unexpected. Floyd's Truck Center, your commercial farm and feed truck center, representing Freightliner, Western Star and Harsh, is at 322 South Beltline Highway East in Scotts Bluff. Northwest will have the ball. Teslock Thong back into the game. He'll inbound it. Hayes hands it back to Thong. Right side pass, Hemme. Hemme, top of the circle to Larson. Now Thong. Now Hayes. Right side, here comes a three-pointer that's an air ball out of bounds by Drew Larson. And Western Nebraska will have the ball with a 10-point lead, 6:25 remaining. Walker will inbound it to J.J. Harris. Harris strolls toward the timeline. He'll be greeted there by Colin Hayes. Bounces a pass to Nation. Nation behind the back on the dribble now spins down low, puts the shot in. He's in doubles with 10, and it's 71-59. Just over 6 minutes to go in the contest. My second game of the day, Western Nebraska lost to Western Wyoming Women and Casper in the first round of the Region 9 tournament up there. Here's Thong on the left side. Bounces it onto the corner. Hayes jumps, gets it back outside to Merritt. Thong, Merritt. Merritt will take the three-pointer. It rims out. Rebound, however, Northwest. Good rebound by Hayes. He takes it in the corner and hits the three. Hayes with 19 in the game now, 11 this half. 71-62, 5.5 minutes to go. Western Nebraska pulls it back out, Easterly with it. Easterly finds a seam on the right side, gets the defender up, and draws the foul. It'll be a non-shooting foul. He got the defender in the air, and I was afraid somebody was going to get hurt there when they came down. But apparently none the worse for the wear for Colin Hayes. That'll be Hayes with his fourth personal foul. So he has four, Merritt has four, and Easterly will be at the line. Easterly's one out of two. This a 1-1. He has to make the first one to earn the bonus. He does so. So he's nearing doubles. He has nine. Harris has 16. Simo has 12. Wilson has 16. Nation has 10. This could be the fifth man in double digits for Western Nebraska. We'll talk on Northwest when we have a chance at the other end. They came into the game with six men averaging in doubles. Easterly hits again. Right now, Merritt has 11 and Hayes has 19 for Northwest. Hemmy's across the timeline. Harris on him defensively. Flips the pass back outside to Hayes. Left side, Merritt. Merritt will find Thong on the right side. Squares up, fakes, dumps it off. Extra pass in the corner to Hayes. Here's Hayes spinning, and he will put a shot up and in. Used the rim to protect, and he has 21. 73-64, Western Nebraska. Harris jumps it off to Nation. He'll launch a three and hit it. Nation with 13 in the game, and there's timeout. Western Nebraska, 76-64, Western Nebraska on the Wesco scoreboard. '76-64, Western Nebraska with the lead in the contest. 4:37 remains. Ryan's Welding sells PJ Texas trailers in a wide variety of sizes, as well as offering a full-service welding shop. Intralinx, supporting computer systems in the Panhandle for over 20 years. With the team at Intralinx, technology isn't an obstacle, it's an opportunity. 12-point lead. It was three with 8:20 to go. It's 62-59. Western Nebraska got a couple of quick hoops after that and expanded the lead. In fact, they had a 9-0 run before Northwest could score again. Northwest has the basketball. They have some excellent shooters. Thong will bring it across. Thong takes a screen left, pulls up, reverses it out. Here's Larson for three, but it's too strong. Rebound Merritt of Northwest as he was in the right place at the right time. Hemi down into the corner. Thong launches. Three's off the back iron, and we're going to have a jump ball. Easterly helps tie up And we're going to have a warning, I think, against Easterly here, as he was just a little feisty there against Coulter Merritt. Possession arrow, favor of Western Nebraska. So with 4:16 to go, still a 12-point lead, 76-64. Little one-man press by Northwest, but Easterly will bring it up. Hemme greets him at the timeline. 4 minutes, 10 seconds to go. Easterly races to the right side, now slows up, comes into the paint. Nice drop step. We're going to have an offensive foul, though, as I think he hooked the defender. He did. So Easterly with his third personal foul. 4:03 to go. 14th turnover on Western Nebraska. Still a 12-point game. And should be 30 on the shot clock here. I think they did not have that set properly. Now do so, and we're ready for action. Hemme takes the inbound from Merritt. Now we're inside 4 minutes as Thong brings it across the timeline for the Trappers of Northwest Wyoming. Hemme out to Merritt. Merritt goes left side to Thong. Here's Hayes. Right side, Hemme behind the screen, misses the three, rebound Maurice Walker. Walker waits for traffic to clear, gets it to J.J. Harris. 3:35 to go as Harris picked up at the timeline, spins away from Hayes, hooks a pass right side, Nation. Three-pointer is too strong, rebound Thong, and we're going to have a foul against Western Nebraska on the rebound attempt there. That's going to be Ovia. And Ovia will pick up his fourth personal foul of the ball game. He has four. Simo has three as the big guys for Western Nebraska. And that puts Thong at the line. Thong has not shot a free throw in the ball game. He'll have one and one. One more foul on Northwest. It'll be the double bonus for Western Nebraska the rest of the way. Two fouls on Western Nebraska will give Northwest that same advantage. Thong rattles it home for his first successful free throw of the ball game. 79% free throw shooter on the year. The team as a whole at 76.8. Looks like we're going to have Hemme take a much-needed breather. That guy's played hard and played a lot of the ball game. Santana comes in. Teslak Thong, 6'2 freshman out of Australia, hits again, so he goes 2 for 2 and makes it a 76-66 game. Western Nebraska, double-digit lead, Harris into the forecourt. Harris, Easterly in the center jump circle with it, back to Harris in front of the Western Nebraska bench, the right side as they look at it. Deep into the corner, Walker hooks it out to Nation. Left side, Easterly. Easterly slips, but keeps the dribble going. No turnover. Now Simo. We're at 6 seconds to go. Ball's knocked away. Nation takes it deep into the left corner, and he stepped out of bounds. A turnover on Western Nebraska. They would have had one on the shot clock violation anyway. 10-point lead with 2:55 to go. Hemme got that breather. He'll come back in. Thong goes out. 10-point Western Nebraska lead, 2:55 remaining in the game. Western Nebraska has had several improbable comebacks this year themselves, so they can't think this one's in the bag. Hayes with it, now Santana. Get the ball to Merritt, top of the circle. Very patient on offense. Here's Hayes. Hayes drives in, and it's rejected by Simo. Walker comes up with the basketball. Walker gives it back to J.J. Harris, and with 2:26 to go, he passes to Easterly in the forecourt. 10-point lead, Western Nebraska. Probably try and take the shot clock fairly deep. Harris with it. Harris spins away, dumps it down low. Nation lays it in. Nation on the nice assist makes it 78-66, Western Nebraska. We're at 2:05 to go. Hemme in no hurry as he brings it across, wanting to make sure they're all set up. Hayes with it on the weave. Now Santana, Merritt, and we're going to have a foul called against Western Nebraska here, I believe, away from the basketball. Yeah, that'll be Easterly picking up his fourth. So Western Nebraska has a pair with four in this game, another with three, and that means 1-1 for the last time in the ball game. Drew Larson will shoot it. Averaging 10.1, he has 2 points. He was scoreless at halftime. He'll hit the free throw, so he earns the bonus. makes it 78-67. Western Nebraska, 11-point lead with a minute 54. I talked earlier, Northwest Kansas, McCook, both victims of Western Nebraska comebacks. Shot goes in again for Larson, so it's 78-68. Let's see, Simo will come out. Let's see, Easterly out. Well, maybe not. Just a timeout's been taken. We'll wait and see. Timeout with a minute 54, 78-68, Western Nebraska on the West Coast scoreboard. Point lead for Western Nebraska to see if they can continue their season in the semifinals of the men's Region 9 tournament tomorrow at Cougar Palace. 5 o'clock and 7 o'clock will be the games. Trinidad and Gillette at 5. Casper and the winner of this one at 7 o'clock. Timeout taken there. Both teams breaking their huddles to come back out. It'll be inbounded down on the baseline against a full-court press by Western Nebraska. Maurice Walker will inbound it. All 5 Western Nebraska players at the timeline or closer to help out in receiving a pass here. Long pass ahead to Nation in the forecourt. He'll go to the right side, reverses it back out into the corner. Doubled, gets it down to Simo. He'll lay it in. Simo with 14 in the ball game. His high 17 this year. Hemi, Santana, Thong, Northwest in the weave. Ball handed off. That'll be Santana driving. He'll put it off the glass. It won't go. Rebound Simo. Simo to Harris. Long pass ahead to Easterly. Easterly puts it in. 82-68. We're just determining a final score now. Minute 16 to go in the ball game. Santana across. Left side to Thong. Thong will pull up for a three. It's blocked by Nation, but picked off by Northwest. Layup won't go for Hayes. Rebound on the floor. Scramble for it, and we'll have a jump ball called. And the possession arrow will be in Northwest's favor. 56.8 seconds to go. Western Nebraska leading it handily now at 82-68. We're going to see Preston Condi come back in. Merritt will go out for Northwest. And the ball will be inbounded by Hemi on the right side. But before that will happen, Halverson wants to report, I believe. Did they get him reported before the ball was handed to Hemi? Yes. So Halverson will come into the ball game. Hemi comes out. Thong will inbound the basketball on the right side, but before he does, two of the officials want to get together and chat for a moment here also. At halftime, it was 35-27 Western Nebraska. We've had no ties, no lead changes in this ball game. Now, after the consultation, we're going to have a timeout taken. 56.8 seconds, 82-68, Western Nebraska on the West Coast scoreboard. For almost 40 years, the name Scottsbluff Body and Paint has meant excellence. Count on them to get you back on the road as good as new. Well, following the timeout, Thong will inbound for Northwest Wyoming, right side of the board. Man-to-man by Western Nebraska, as always. Thong can't find anybody outside. He'll get the ball deep. Condi out to Halverson. He'll lay it in. Halverson, strong move to the hoop for his 7th point, but well below his average, 82-70. Western Nebraska Harris out on top. Thong on him, but he's just trying to use some time up. Now he'll blow by the double team, gets the ball low, but it's knocked away by Halverson, recovered by Northwest. Northwest into the forecourt. Nice no-look pass by Thong, and the little left-handed hook by Preston Condi goes in. He's in doubles with 11. That's over double what he normally has. Harris across, just won't give up, gets it down low, and Nation puts it down. 84-72, 18 seconds to go. Thong to Halverson, left corner. He'll drive, puts the shot up, gets his own rebound as it comes away. Outside with it to Condi. He fakes, gives it away to a new player, Carter Clark, in for the first time. He'll miss the three. Rebound, Western Nebraska, and there's the buzzer. So Western Nebraska will move on. Their 12th straight win on the year. They're now 23-8. Both teams put a bunch of points up in the second after not scoring a lot in the first half. Northwest put 45 points up. Western Nebraska, 49. Final, 84-72, Western Nebraska. Western Nebraska wins it 84-72. They'll match up with Casper in the 7 o'clock ball game tomorrow night here at Cougar Palace in the Men's Region 9 tournament. Western Nebraska led it throughout. There were no ties, no lead changes. Jumped out 4-0, led it at halftime 35-27. However, Northwest kept battling. They cut it to 3 points at 62-59 with 8:20 to go after Western Nebraska had several double-digit leads, but a couple of key hoops, then a free throw, and all of a sudden it was 67-59, then 69-59, 71-59 on a 9-0 run. So at 6:05 to go, it was back to a double-digit lead. It was cut inside doubles a couple of times by Northwest, but Western Nebraska equal to the challenge the rest of the way. And they pick up the win 84-72. We're waiting for the official stat sheet. Looks like they're having some trouble with the printer down the way. Modern conveniences. So we'll take one more break, and then we'll start looking at the scoring in this one as Western Nebraska wins it over the Northwest Wyoming Trappers 84-72. Thank you. trouble with the printer, I think, so they can't get stats down to us.
Can't all go right, can it?
No. And I'm off 1 point. I put a 3 down for one of us. I'm waiting for the stats to make sure I can get them right. But... I'm stalling. Well, before we get into all the scoring in this one, and they're having some problems printing everything off, and I have one Western Nebraska player apparently I gave a 3 to that isn't right. But we have the coach with us, and boy, several different ways we can go on this one. 6 players averaging double digits for Northwest. They end with 3, and one of the big changes, Colin Hayes only had 1 point out in Powell. He had 21 to lead them tonight, so it does show how things can change night to night.
Well, no doubt about that, and if you go through his conference season, I mean, he had a heck of a conference season. He averaged 21, actually, in conference. The game that we played against him up there, it was, I think, only his second game back after an injury, so he was kind of finding his legs, and, you know, he did 4 turnovers, was like 0 for 1 from the field, like 1 for 3 from the free throw line, and he has really found his legs here in conference season, and he was a big focal point for us defensively, and he did a good job, you know, regardless of how seriously we took him. He's a heck of a player.
Yes, he is. And on the other side, regardless of that 3 that I'm talking about that may have been a 2, you had 5 guys in doubles.
Well, you know what? We've said it all year. We've got enough guys that can score it. You know, even when we take some questionable shots at times, you know, we do have some talented players that can make some shots. Our emphasis has been the better shots that we take, the better we're going to be, and the more defense and rebounding that we can put out there on the floor, the better we're going to be. But good to see some shots fall after 20 days off.
Simo and Ovia both got into some foul trouble there. Simo ended with 3, Ovia with 4, and he had his 4th with 3:25 to go. But Simo is 3rd with 10:51. They were all in the second half. You pulled him at that point. Sometimes it's kind of hard to get guys back into the flow of things when they come out like that.
Yeah, you know, finding a rhythm on the floor is something that all players want to do to find some comfortability. But we try to tell our guys is at the highest levels of basketball, you got to be ready to go no matter what. You know, if you're used to a normal routine of starting games, playing 5-6 minutes, getting pulled, and then coming back in 3-4 minutes later, you know, when there's a change in your routine, you've got to be able to step up to the challenge. You got to show up and perform no matter what. You got to step out there, and no matter what, you've got to defend every possession. You've got to rebound every possession. You've got to make smart choices every possession, regardless if you're in and out of rhythm. Making and missing shots isn't going to be the end of the world. You know, defending and rebounding is far more important for us.
Yeah. Free throwing, boy, you ended up 14 out of 17, 4 of 6 at halftime, 14 of 17 in the game. Northwest 12 out of 17. That was kind of marred by Coulter Merritt in that first half. Just you could tell he didn't want to be 15 feet from the hoop.
Well, you know what? The funny thing is we were looking at their free throw percentages as a team, seeing if this game gets late and we need to foul somebody, let's look at some percentages here and see who's really good at the line. And he does not shoot a bad percentage on the season.
You're right.
Now, he did not look comfortable tonight. A couple of those misses came off a little bit funky, but you know, he does shoot a good percentage on the year for us. You know, we've had some really good free throw shooters, in my opinion, not shoot great percentages on the season. So good to see our guys step up and, you know, take advantage at the line.
Let's turn our attention to tomorrow night. You've played Casper once. That was on this court. first game of the year for both of you. Casper ended up with a 6-point win.
Yep, you know, and we look back at that one kind of throughout the first semester as a we really let one slip. You know, we had a really talented opponent. You know, we had them I want to say kind of right where we wanted them. You know, with 7 or 8 minutes to go in that game, and we let a really talented opponent kind of slip through our hands. And I don't know if it just weren't quite ready for the moment, had to knock the rust off, whatever it may be. But we've kind of been kicking ourselves for that one. Our guys have been talking about that one. Man, I wish we could have that Casper game back. So credit to us for getting a first round win, and really excited to see Casper tomorrow night.
What's your evaluation? This is probably a question I'll ask you in the pregame tomorrow also. Your evaluation of how this team has improved throughout the year?
Immensely. And the best thing about how we've improved is